हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम प्रोफेसर पल्लवी देवकाते। वेलकम्स यू इन फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑफ इकोन 355, कोर्स टाइटल दैट इज स्ट्रक्चर एंड डायनामिक्स ऑफ इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड द फ्रेगमेंटेशन एंड सब डिवीजन ऑफ लैंड होल्डिंग इन इंडिया। इन दिस टॉपिक वी कवर डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स सच एज meaning and definition of land fragmentation, types of land fragmentation. Also, we studied causes of fragmentation and subdivision of land holding. And lastly, we see the advantages and disadvantages of land fragmentation. In today's session, we see the consolidation of land holding in India. So, before starting actual consolidation, we study the remedies for subdivision and fragmentation of holding. So, to tackle the problem of subdivision and fragmentation, economic holding are to be created, and this creation of economic holding requires following three major policies. These policies are: first one, that is consolidation of land holding; second one is consolidation through cooperatives; and third policy, that is fragmentation in future, is prohibited. So we go through these different policies. First policy from creation of economic holding, that is consolidation. So firstly, we study the meaning and definition of consolidation. So consolidation, it is one of the best remedies for land fragmentation. Even the planning commission has said that in all the state, programs of consolidation should be expanded. So first of all, we see the definition of consolidation. So consolidation means the bringing in one compact block all the plots of land of a cultivator which are scattered all over the village. That is called as consolidation. Okay, so consolidation, it is opposite to that of fragmentation. In fragmentation, we see the fragmentation means it is the division of land holding into the smaller plot and which are scattered all over the village, and this consolidation means it is the bringing together the smaller blocks of land and make the one compact block. That is called as consolidation of land holding. Another definition of consolidation, that is, it is a plan readjustment and rearrangement of fragmented land parcel and their ownership. That is, it is the readjustment and rearrangement of scattered land holding into one compact block. That is called as consolidation of land holding. Okay, here consolidation of land indicate the bringing smaller scattered plots of land into one compact block and then divide the compact blocks among the farmer in a compact manner. In India, the consolidation was initiated on voluntary basis and later on it is made compulsory. Okay, so majority state have already made sufficient provision for implementation of scheme of consolidation of land holding, but the progress of consolidation is not up to mark, and again it is not uniform among all the states. However, the implementation has been extremely patchy and sporadic. Only in state of Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh, work is completed. Even there is no any beginning in the southern state like Rajasthan, and in eastern state some work is just beginning like Orissa and Bihar. So in short, the consolidation means comprehensive land reallocation procedure which is combined with provision of public facilities for defined rural areas to improve the land tenure structure and promote the land development for certain land use. Okay, so this is all about consolidation meaning and definition. Okay, so in short, consolidation is nothing but the bringing of one compact block of all the plots of land which are scattered all over the village is known as consolidation. After consolidation, we see different components of land consolidation. So there are major two components of land consolidation. In that first one, that is land readjustment, it is also known as land reallocation. And second component, that is agrarian special planning. These are the two components of land consolidation. We see one by one these two components of consolidation. In that first one is land readjustment. So this land readjustment involves the rearrangement of ownership in terms of parcel, that is size, shape, location and right, that is land exchange right, and is the core issue of each land consolidation approach. Okay, so this land readjustment activity has been defined in terms such as reorganization, regrouping, rearrangement, reparceling, reallotment, reconfiguration and redistribution of land holding. So this is the first component of land consolidation, that is land readjustment. After that, second component, that is agrarian special planning. So this agrarian special planning involves the provision of necessary infrastructure such as roads, irrigation system, drainage system, landscaping, environmental management, village renewal, soil conservation, etc. for the development of land. So these are the two major components of land consolidation. In that first one, that is land readjustment, and second one is agrarian special planning. After components of consolidation, we see the different principles of land consolidation. Okay, so these principles of land consolidation was suggested by FAO in 2003. So these principles are, first one, it should be improved rural livelihood. Second one, sustainable economic and political development. Third one, process should be participatory, democratic and community driven. Fourth one, that is management of natural resources. And fifth one, that is comprehensive and cross-sectorial integrating element of rural and border the regional development. Okay, so we see one by one this principle. So first principle, that is it should be improve rural livelihood. So this consolidation must improve the rural livelihood rather than to improve only the primary production of agricultural product. Okay, and this improvement in rural living can be achieved in many ways through consolidation. For example, by protecting and enhancing the nature and environment, by providing necessary development infrastructure such as road, drainage, irrigation networks, etc. Also by implementing village renewal measures, etc. So some of these measures may be provided new opportunities to the farmer for further agricultural development such as agrotourism, small scale industries, etc. Okay, so this is the first principle of land consolidation, that is to improve rural livelihood. Second principle, that is sustainable economic and political development. So end result of community renewal through sustainable economic and political development of whole community and protection and sustainable management of natural resource. So this land consolidation may effectively address the problem of land fragmentation, and it also can be powerful instrument for sustainable rural development. After that, third principle, that is process should be participatory and democratic. So this process of land consolidation, it must be participatory, democratic and community driven in practice, not only in a concept. Okay, that means it must be practically applicable. So it must be participatory, that means all the villagers must be participate in that particular process. Then it must be democratic. So as like democratic, this process of land consolidation is democratic and community driven. So this land consolidation is the traditionally participatory process. However, there is a gap in terms of incorporating the new technologies into the participatory process. Okay, after that, fourth principle, that is management of natural resource. So it is one of the principle of land consolidation. It is necessary to ensure the life for next generation. Land consolidation project can also play an important role in the management of natural resource, especially regarding the protection of land and water by facilitating a better land use planning. So this is one of the principle of land consolidation, that is management of natural resource. After that, fifth principle, that is this land consolidation approach should be comprehensive, cross-sectorial and integrating element of rural development as well as regional development, including rural-urban linkages. Okay, so this land consolidation is essential to reduce the disparities between urban and rural areas. Urban, rural and regional programs should be elaborated under integrated policies and aimed at balancing conflicts and reducing the disparities between rural and urban areas. So these are the different principles of land consolidation, in which first one, that is to improve the rural livelihood, it is sustainable economic and political development. Then this process of land consolidation should be participatory, democratic and community driven, and it must protect the natural resources. And last one is, it is comprehensive and cross-sectorial process. Okay, so this is all about the principles of land consolidation. After principles of land consolidation, we see the different types of land consolidation. So there are major five types of land consolidation. In that, first one is rural land consolidation, second one is forestry land consolidation, third one, that is urban land consolidation, fourth one regional land consolidation, and fifth one is environmental land consolidation. We see one by one these different types of land consolidation. In that, first one, that is rural land consolidation. So this rural land consolidation, it is both traditional as well as modern form of land consolidation, and mainly this rural land consolidation is related with development of rural areas. Okay, after that, second type of land consolidation, that is forestry land consolidation. So this land consolidation mainly focuses on improving protection and working condition of forest area, especially the regulation concerning woodland are applied. This land consolidation includes land allocation, road construction, landscape development measures, and sometimes it is applied in combination with rural land consolidation. So mainly this forestry land consolidation, it is related with improving the production and working condition of forest area. After that, third type of land consolidation, that is urban land consolidation. So this urban land consolidation, it is referred as land readjustment and land pooling. Okay, so in urban land consolidation, it is the method whereby an irregular pattern of agriculture holding is rearranged into regular building plots and which are equipped with basic urban infrastructure such as road, drainage system, etc. And the land readjustment is simply method by which the city government and other design public bodies or even private associate can participate easily. So this is all about urban consolidation. So mainly this urban consolidation, it is related with urban infrastructure and urban development. Okay, after that, fourth one, that is regional land consolidation. So this regional land consolidation, it is applied when land is required for construction of major public project such as road, airports, railways, dams, etc. In these cases, a well planned and implemented consolidation scheme can be improve the yield of agriculture in that particular area. In addition to providing major restructuring of land, and the core aim of the land consolidation is to reduce the conflicts between land owners and the government arising from necessary acquisition of land. So this regional land consolidation, mainly it is related with some major public project such as road infrastructure, then development of airport, then railways and dams, etc. After that, last one, that is environmental land consolidation. So this environmental land consolidation, it is implemented with specific objective of improving and protecting the environment. So main aim of this environmental consolidation is protection and improvement of environment, the landscape and nature generally. Okay, so in this environmental, landscape, nature and environment is protected and improved. For example, land consolidation project can be applied to protect the lake or river by reorganization land tenure structure or to create national park. In the countries like Denmark, Germany, Netherlands, the many nature and environmental projects are implemented through this land consolidation procedure. Okay, so this is all about types of land consolidation in which we studied. First one is rural land consolidation, forestry, urban, regional and environmental land consolidation. Okay, after types of consolidation, next point is advantages of land consolidation. So in 2003, the Food and Agricultural Organization, they recognize the different capabilities or advantages of land consolidation. These are, first one, it can lead to improvement in agriculture. Second one, it can promote improved management of natural resource. Third one, it can improve rural development. And fourth one, it can improve the land administration system. So we see one by one these advantages. So first one, that is, it can improve the agriculture. So this land consolidation has been shown it is most effective tool for limiting land fragmentation, and also it is one of the best tool for effective restructuring of land tenure system. Okay, so this land consolidation, it is considered as a one of the best solution or remedies for reduction of land fragmentation. As a result of this, the rational agricultural development is done, and which ultimately facilitate the consequent benefit to the farmer. That means farmers' income is increased as there is rational development in agriculture. So this is the first advantage, that is improvement in agriculture. Okay, second advantage, that is promote the improved management of natural resource. So rationalizing the tenure structure can facilitate the environmental protection, and it also support the better land use planning and land management. Also this land consolidation solve the most of the land tenure structure problem and promote the environmental protection. So this land tenure structures, which may have substantial influence on geoecological and bioecological resources, and these land consolidation. Also, the better land use planning and land management of natural resource can be achieved through solving public and private conflict. So this land consolidation can improve the management of natural resource. Third one, that is, it can improve the rural development. So this rural development can be achieved through different project oriented land consolidation scheme, which may facilitate the efficiency and cost effectiveness of public and private investment in transportation, communication networks, utilities and irrigation system. This land consolidation project, which may be at the heart of integrated rural development programs by providing the means and infrastructure to support the provision and aims of this program. So by providing different project oriented land consolidation scheme, it improve the rural development. Okay, fourth advantage, that is, it can improve the land administration system. So this land consolidation provide an opportunity to clarify and update the land ownership records, and this clear and updated land ownership record gives better quality land information system, and which facilitate the reliability and hence the development of land market and management of land conflicts. It is also support the social and political stability in developing countries or for smooth transition to the free market of economy of ex-communist countries. So this land consolidation can help to improve the land administration system by clarifying and updating the land ownership record. Okay, so this is all about the advantages of land consolidation. Okay, after the advantages, next we see the disadvantages of land consolidation. In that first one, this land consolidation causes negative effect when it is applied in the areas where land fragmentation is beneficial and it does not constitute a serious problem. Okay, so in the areas which are land fragmentation is beneficial, in that areas land consolidation create negative effect. After that, second one is impacting natural resource or natural environment. So many infrastructural project land consolidation causes some effect in natural environment, such as air pollution, soil pollution, etc. Next disadvantage is, as the field size increase and area of cultivation, which destroy the sense of variety which is provided by land fragmentation. Okay, after that, next one is, by removing the hedges and physical partial or physical boundaries which are used as a green fencing and provide habitat for wildlife. So this wildlife habitat and green fencing can be removed due to this land consolidation. After that, next point is increase the wind and water erosion by removing the barriers which are created by boundaries. After that, next disadvantage is adding extra infrastructure which destroy the land and create pollution. Okay, so due to the land consolidation, pollution is also created. Next one, social impact of land consolidation is generation of landless people. And last one, the process of land consolidation, such as high cost and long duration of project, also the public participation and land valuation. So it is very lengthy process, also costly process and time consuming process. So these are the different disadvantages of land consolidation. After disadvantages of land consolidation, last point, that is difficulties or failure of land consolidation in India. So there are different reasons which are responsible for failure of consolidation in India. These are, first one, that is farmers too much attachment to their ancestral land, so they are unwilling to surrender their land for consolidation. So this is the one of the most important factor which is responsible for failure of land consolidation, that is emotional attachment of farmer to their ancestral land, and due to this attachment they are unwilling to surrender his land for consolidation. Next factor, that is farmer have fear to get inferior block after consolidation. Okay, so if farmer having superior quality of land and after consolidation he have fear to get inferior block. Next factor is, as the farmers are illiterate, they do not understand the full implication of benefits of consolidation. Okay, the most of the Indian farmers are illiterate, so they do not understand the benefits of consolidation. Next one, that is lack of trained staff. So for the process of consolidation there is lack of trained staff. This is one of the major factor which responsible for land consolidation. Next one, the consolidation cost money and difficulty of finding finance. So it is very costly process, so needs lots of money, and it is very difficult to find out the financing sources for consolidation. And last one, lengthy process, that is time consuming process. And lastly, lack of cooperation from poor and small farmer, because small farmer and poor farmer having small size of land holding and there is no cooperation from small and poor farmers for the consolidation of land. This cooperative farming can be considered as permanent solution towards the problem of land subdivision and fragmentation in India. Through this cooperative farming, the small and scattered farm can be consolidated in India. The main merit of this cooperative farming is it is voluntary basis, that means there is no any compulsion. So it is rest upon the persuasion of landholders concern. Once the voluntary agreement is sponsored by cooperative consolidation of holding society, the result are permanent. Okay, so these are the consolidation through cooperatives. So there are some difficulties in cooperative consolidation, in which first one, it is slow, that means it is slow process. Then indebtedness of plots on large scale, so there is large debt or credit on the plots. Next one, lethargy in attitude of people, then sentimental to land and want to adequate areas of same kind of land for exchange. Next difficulty is lack of adequate and persistent propaganda. And last one, that is lack of efficient staff to carry out legislative measures of cooperatives. So this is the second policy, that is consolidation through cooperatives. Last policy in creation of economic holding is restriction on further subdivision and fragmentation of land. So consolidation in itself offers no permanent solution. The problem is likely to recur with every new generation. So restriction is therefore necessary on future partition, exchange and transfer of land holding. So this subdivision of farm can be prevented through different measures. In that, first one is change in law of inheritance, and second one is subdivision of land only up to certain stage, beyond which there is restriction on subdivision of land. So this is all about the fourth lecture, that is consolidation of land holding. So question may be asked on this topic, like give the remedies of land fragmentation, or sometimes question may be asked like define land consolidation, explain different types of consolidation along with advantages and disadvantages. Okay, so this is all about the consolidation of land holding. Okay, thank you all.